couldn't even take one stripe. Hallelujah, Jesus. But he took 39. Hallelujah. After we got two, we would have been dead. Hallelujah, Jesus. So we can never relate. Hallelujah to what he did on the cross. Hallelujah. That blessed me. Hallelujah, Jesus. So stay right there, right there, right there. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. I may be with you for a minute. Hallelujah. But let me give it to you how God gave it to me. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. First and foremost, hallelujah, I want to give God the praises. Also praise the leaders of our house. Hallelujah, all the ministers, the pastors, you know who you are. Everybody in their respectable places. God, I ask that you use me for your glory, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Let your word go out and fall on good ground, God. And produce good fruit, God. That it may bring about a change in their lives after today, God. In the name of Jesus. If you want a scripture, I give you a scripture. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hebrews 10, 11 through 18. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Hebrews 10, 11 through 18.
All right, God.
That's all right, amen.
Amen. Go ahead.
Amen. So I'm just going to read from here real quick just to give you a scripture. It says that, and every priest stands ministering daily and offering repeatedly the sacrifices which can never take away sin. But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for the sins forever, sat down at the right hand of God from that time waiting till his enemies are made his footstool.
Come on, all right.
For by one offering, he had perfected forever those who are being sanctified.
My God.
But the Holy Spirit also witnessed to us. For after he had said before, this is my covenant that I will make with them after those days, says the Lord. And I will put my laws into their hearts and into their minds. And I will write them. Amen. Then he adds, their sins and their lawlessness deeds I will remember no more. There is no longer an offering for sin. Amen. So I'm talking about my topic today, amen, is about the sacrificial lamb. He paid the ultimate price. After he paid that price, he went on to say here in his word that you ain't got to pay it no more. He said he paid the ultimate price. Amen. He said then God went on to say, now after that, he made that atonement. Now I'm going to put it in the heart. You know what? I'm going to write it in their hearts. Amen. That they will remember it. Amen. So I just wanted to give you that scripture. Amen. But I got to talk about the sacrificial lamb. And talking about the sacrificial lamb, we got to talk about the blood. Yeah. What the blood represents. The blood represents life.
Yes.
For life was, the blood was shed for the atonement of sin. Yes. But the blood was sacred unto God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm going to travel, so you're going to have to take some notes. Amen. Genesis 9 and 4 talks about, he said, but ye should not eat of the flesh, which is life, that is the blood. So the blood is considered sacred, amen. He even said that you can't even eat of the blood. If something has the blood in it, God say you're not supposed to eat it with the blood in it. That is the significance of the blood. It said that life of the flesh, amen, Leviticus 17 and 11. It said, for the life of the flesh is in the blood. He said, I have given to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that makes the atonement for your sins. Amen. And we all know that the altar is a place where you go, a sacred offering.
Yes.
When you go, they have to present an offering, amen, unto the Lord. And the atonement will make, you know, make it right with God. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus stood in the gap when he made the atonement for our sins. He paid the ultimate price, amen, which was the blood atonement. Could nothing else take away the sin but the blood, amen.
Right.
So the blood is very sacred in our life. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
You may receive the atonement by only a sacrifice of life. Amen. You know, in regard to atonement, amen, it had to be some shedding of some blood. Some blood had to be shed in order to make an atonement. Back doing that a lot of time, amen,
yes,
for the remission of their sin.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And it said that, you know, yet we was dead, but we have been restored.
Yes.
When the blood was shed, amen, it brought about a restoration.
Yes.
Amen. And that's why they had to shed the blood by then, amen, to be restored back to the place of God.
Yes.
The blood shed it when we had sin The blood brought about a separation from God. So God had, somebody had to shed a blood in order to bring us back to God. Amen. Because when we sin, it brought about a separation. Oh, but the blood. We was on our way to hell. Amen. We was on our way. Hallelujah. But thank God for the blood. Only the blood could have put us back in right standing with God. When we have opportunity to enter into the pearly gates, as they said, to see him on that great day. Oh God, I thank you for the blood. Hallelujah. When it's a sacrificial lamb, it costs some blood. Amen. The blood also represents the covenant. Exodus 24:7-8. It said that he took the book of the covenant and read it in the audience of the people. Then he sprinkled the blood on the people. And he said, and this is Moses during that time, amen. And then he said, this is the blood of the covenant, yes, which the Lord had made with you according to his will. Yes, yes. According to his word, amen. Yes. The blood brought on a covenant, amen. Yes. So after they read the word, hallelujah, when he read the book of the covenant to them, the book of the covenant was the instructions, amen, yes, and the judgment that God put in place in regards to how he wanted them to live, yes, which is the word of God, amen. Yes. So when he made them, when he brought it into their knowledge and to their understanding, he sprinkled the blood,
yes, he did,
over the people, hallelujah. And that brought up into covenant is what was in the book of the covenant.
Yes. Come on,
amen. So we came into agreement underneath the blood.
Yes.
The blood brought them into the covenant. Yes. Even during the Passover, the blood brought them into the covenant. Every house that was covered underneath the blood, the death passed over. So they was in covenant with God.
Yes.
Amen. So everybody that wasn't covered underneath the blood cost it their life.
Yes.
So see, you had to come into the covenant,
yes,
with the Lord. So the blood brings us into the covenant.
Uh-huh.
The people under the Passover was covered underneath the blood, which was the blood covenant of God.
Yes.
And we also know that back during that time, that was the old covenant. The new covenant was the shedding of the blood that made the sacrifice for all.
Yes.
The old blood covenant represented through the law covered them during that time.
Yes.
But when Jesus made the ultimate sacrifice, he brought on the new covenant.
Come on.
With the shedding of the blood made the sacrifice for everyone.
Come on.
Now all of us are covered underneath the blood.
Yes.
Because of the price of the sacrificial lamb. He paid the ultimate price that brought us back into the covenant underneath the blood.
Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Jesus.
I need for you to go, if you want to travel, to Galatians 4:21-23. I'm using this as an example to show you about the blood. The blood covenant, amen. Abraham had two sons. One was born under the bondwoman according to the flesh, and the other one was born underneath, hallelujah, the free woman, which is according to the promise.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
If you didn't catch that, hallelujah, Jesus.
Jesus.
He had two sons.
Yes.
One represented the flesh, hallelujah,
yes,
and one represented the promise.
Come on,
the law represented the flesh, and the sacrificial lamb represented the promise.
Yes.
Which brought us underneath the new covenant.
Yes.
Hallelujah, which is the blood covenant,
yes,
which
on,
was a part of the promise.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus. So we have to come into the covenant of God.
Yes.
Oh God, hallelujah, the blood.
Yes.
I just saying the blood. The blood represents a covenant.
Jesus.
He didn't stop there with his covenant, hallelujah, Jesus. If we go to Matthew 26:26-29. It said, when I drink ye, they was all sitting having the Last Supper. He said, drink ye all of you. For this is my blood,
my God,
of the new covenant,
yes,
that I shall shed for many, and that you won't drink it again, he said, until I meet you.
Yes.
Till I meet you in the new kingdom.
Yes.
But not only did he give us a covenant when he paid the sacrifice for our sin,
yes,
but he also went on to tell us that, hey, I'm going to meet you on the other side.
Come
in
on.
The new kingdom.
Come
I'm coming you underneath the blood.
Yes.
That if you make it through all of this, hallelujah, and you take upon the blood covenant, hallelujah,
yes,
you will reign with me in the new kingdom.
Come on now.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, the sacrificial lamb. Sacrificial lamb. Hallelujah, the sacrificial lamb. He paid the ultimate price. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, when we talk about the sacrificial lamb, you got to understand what it means to pay a sacrifice. A sacrifice was in reference to a person or an animal that they used to kill for a common good. You had to shed some blood, hallelujah, to be a sacrifice, hallelujah. And then the lamb. A lamb was something that they highly valued, amen. It was a highly valued possession, hallelujah. But it was offered to God as a sacrifice, hallelujah, to obtain a more highly favored.
My God.
Hallelujah, Jesus. So this was.